Did you know that you can cache your local builds and reuse them across your entire team? With SDK 53, Expo introduced an experimental feature called Remote Build Cache. It lets you skip the native recompilation if a matching build already exists in a remote cache. Here's how it works. You build your app once, and Expo caches the build on EAS servers. Next time, if your project's fingerprint matches, you can reuse the existing build even if another teammate created it. The best part? You can use EAS, GitHub, or even implement your own cache provider. Let's see it in action. The only config you need is to update your app.json under experiments, since this is an experimental feature at the moment. Keep that in mind, by the way. You just have to add build cache provider and set that equal to EAS. I'm going to leave the link in the description to documentation in case you want to implement GitHub or your own cache provider. We have fully working examples that you can check out down here. So in this case, I'm going to be using EAS. And the next thing that you need to do is install the dev dependency EAS build cache provider. Once we configure our project to use the remote cache, we can run EAS build dev, passing the platform Android. Let's go ahead and hit enter. This is going to ask me if I want to generate a new profile. So let's go ahead and say yes. What this is doing is just updating my EAS JSON, and it's adding this specific profile that is optimized for using the cache. Since this is the first time that I'm running this command, there are no cache builds that I can use. So it's asking me if I want to install the development client. I'm going to say yes. Let's generate the Android credentials by saying yes. And now the build is in progress. All right, and the build is ready finally. Let's go ahead and open my camera. I'm going to scan the QR code and just download this build. All right, let's go ahead and install it. And let me start my local server. All right, let's pull it from the local host. And my app is working. Awesome. And the to-dos should be fetched now. Ah, great. So this means this build is now cached. Once cached, your team can reuse the build as long as the fingerprint matches. Most JavaScript changes won't break the cache, but if you add a native dependency, just rebuild and cache again. Notice that my project does not have an Android folder. And if I stop the server and delete my app, let's delete it. All right. So I don't have anything. Let's go ahead and run EAS build dev, and we can specify the platform Android, hit enter. And it successfully found the build, but it's not detecting my device that is connected. So let's select the Pixel 9. All right, and I'm going to select the Pixel 9. And boom, just like that, my build is installed. And I have a little error. Let's just go ahead and start the server and refresh on the right. Okay, let's select it. And now this is working. So we instantly installed a fully native application. This is a development build, and I can close it so that everyone can see it here. Let's see how now this process would look like for one of your teammates. So here I have a different computer, and I'm going to run EAS build platform Android. I just cloned this project, hit enter. And after a moment, it's going to check that the fingerprint is matching. And it's just going to install it on my Android device. Again, guys, this is a fully native application. It's a development build. Didn't have to install anything. And there we have it, a fully functional development build installed in seconds just by utilizing the cache build. That's it. Faster builds, fewer resources, and smoother team workflows. Thanks for watching.